Today you are going to see another application of Gauss's law. Electric field due to a thin hollow conducting sphere. So we will consider a very thin sphere, a hollow sphere. So this is a very thin hollow sphere having a radius capital R. It is fully charged, and let Q be the charge on the surface of the sphere. So the charge will remain on the surface of the sphere. Let Q be the charge. R is the radius of the hollow conducting sphere. So we can say the surface area of the conducting sphere will be 4 pi R square. So surface charge density. What is surface charge density? Total charge by surface area. So we can say it is equal to Q by 4 pi R square. This is the surface charge density. Now our aim is to find electric field at a point P somewhere here, outside the sphere. So I am locating a point P somewhere here, and locating a point P. I need to find the total electric intensity at this point due to the entire charged spherical shell, thin spherical shell. So the entire charged spherical shell produces electric field at this point, and we need to get equation for the electric field. So what we are doing, usually when we are going to apply Gauss's law, what we will do, we will consider Gaussian surface. The Gaussian surface should be symmetrical to the charge distribution. So for a spherical surface, the symmetrical shape will be another sphere. So I am considering a Gaussian sphere. This is a Gaussian sphere, including the point P. This is a Gaussian sphere. So I am going to apply Gauss's law with respect to the Gaussian sphere. My aim is to find electric intensity at the point P. And the point P is at a distance small r from the center of the sphere. I need to find the total field at this point P. So the electric field at point P is directed radially outward. So E is the direction of the electric field at the point P. I am going to consider a very small surface of area dA. As we have done in the previous cases, this is a small area having a value dA. And also the area vector. This is small area having a value dA, and the area vector is directed away from the area perpendicular to it. So this will be the area vector dA, vector dA, and this is the electric field vector. Both are in the same direction. So we will apply Gauss's law for the entire Gaussian surface. Now the small flux through the small area, it is d phi. D phi is equal to small flux. D phi is equal to, we have the equation E dot dA. But E and dA are in same direction, so it will be equal to E into dA into cos 0, because angle between E and dA is 0. This is small flux. Now total flux, total flux phi is equal to integral, closed surface integral, E into dA. Cos 0 is 1, so E into dA. And we know that at each and every point on the Gaussian surface, it is equidistant from the center, so electric field will be constant, so we can take it outside. So our total flux is equal to E integral surface integral dA. Now what is dA? dA means the small area. Now when you take integral of dA, it will be equal to the full surface area of the Gaussian sphere. So it will be equal to E into A. Integrating dA, you will get A. So E into A, this will be the flux. Now what will be area, surface area of the Gaussian sphere? Sphere has a surface area 4 pi r square. R means small r. This is capital R and this is small r. So I will substitute phi is equal to E into 4 pi r square. This is the total flux. Now we are going to apply Gauss's law. Gauss's law says that the total flux will be equal to, total flux is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times the net charge enclosed. This sphere, charged sphere, is fully within the Gaussian surface. So the entire charge is within the Gaussian sphere. So entire charge is within the sphere. We can say 1 by epsilon 0 times net charge is Q. So this is the left side of Gauss's law, and this will be the right side. So equating 1 by epsilon 0 times Q is equal to E into 4 pi R square. Now we need intensity. So intensity at the point P is equal to, rearranging the terms, you will get Q by 4 pi R square comes to the denominator, Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. Rearranging, you will get E is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. This is the electric field at this point P due to the charged thin hollow conducting sphere. Q is a charge. Now we can transform this equation in terms of sigma. Sigma is called surface area density. Here we have Q. We need to replace Q. How can you replace Q? Q is equal to sigma into 4 pi r square. So Q is equal to sigma into 4 pi r square. So I am going to substitute here. You will get E is equal to sigma into 4 pi r square divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 small r square. So 4 pi cancels. You will get electric field is equal to sigma r square by epsilon 0 r square. This is the equation for electric field at a point P. The point P is outside the charged thin hollow conducting sphere. This is the equation for electric field. Okay. Now we are going to consider another point. So this point is outside the sphere. Now I am going to consider another point. The point P not outside the sphere, exactly on the surface of the sphere. So the point is on the surface. So let P be the point here. P is here on the surface. P is here. So when P is considered here, this is small r, this is actually capital R. Capital R and small r, both having same length. So what we are to do, to find the electric field at the surface, we can use the same equation. Here R and R, both R will have same value. So what will be the electric field on the surface? On surface, we will get E is equal to sigma R square by epsilon 0 small r square. R square we have to replace by capital R square. Epsilon 0 capital R square cancels, what will you get? Sigma by epsilon 0. So at any point on the surface of the sphere, you have got the equation sigma by epsilon 0. This is the second result. This is first result and this is the second result. Now I am going to consider the point P not on the surface, inside the surface. So I am going to replace the surface. So I am going to draw once again. This is capital R. Now my point is the point where I need to find the electric intensity. The point is inside the sphere. This is the point P. So what I will do, I will draw the Gaussian surface here, including the point P. Now applying Gauss's law, we see that the Gaussian surface does not enclose any charge because charge is outside. So charge enclosed will be, net charge enclosed will be zero because the point P is inside the sphere. So what will be the electric field inside the sphere? Since it does not enclose any charge, electric field will be zero. This is the third result. So we have got three values. Outside you have got sigma r square by epsilon 0 r square. Inside you go on the surface, you got sigma by epsilon 0. Inside you have got the value zero. Now we can plot a graph also. Based on the results, we can plot a graph. Now to plot the graph, we need to see how the electric field varies with the distance from the center. From center of the sphere, we need to plot the variation of electric field. So this is the electric field along x-axis. Along y-axis, we will plot the distance. This is center of the sphere. This is the radius from center to the surface. This distance is the radius. This is small r. Now we know that inside, this is inside. So at each and every point, inside these regions are considering the region inside the sphere. But we know the inside the sphere electric field is zero. This is inside, inside is zero. So we have electric field value zero inside, electric field is zero, value zero. Now on the surface, electric field is sigma by epsilon, so it's a constant value. Sigma by epsilon zero. Sigma is constant, epsilon zero is a constant. So it has a constant value. I will write the constant value here. The constant value is sigma by epsilon zero. So suddenly it increases from zero to the constant value on the surface. This is on the surface. On the surface of the sphere, because R is a radius. It has constant value. Then outside, means outside the sphere. Outside the sphere, we have the equation E is equal to sigma R square by epsilon zero R square. These terms are constants. But R square is not constant. We can say E proportional to 1 by r square. Now we need to plot the variation electric field with the distance square, inversely related, square of the inversely related to square of the distance. So we plot a graph outside, it will have a shape like this. It will have a curve like this. So this is the shape of the graph outside the thin hollow conducting spherical shell. This is the graph. So this is the region inside the sphere. This is on the surface and this is outside. Here we can write also electric field is 0. Here electric field is sigma by epsilon 0. Here electric field is proportional to 1 by r square. So three regions. Inside, on the surface and outside. So this is showing the variation of electric field at three regions from center with the distance. Okay, thank you.